CBC Kids News, this is Mission Control Houston. Please call station for a voice check.
I said, station, this is Saara. How do you hear me? Right out of a movie.
Station, this is Houston. Are you ready for the event?
Houston, this is station. I'm ready. Hey, Saara, I have you loud and clear.
When I spoke to you before you left.
So what has been the most exciting aspect of your training?
You said that one of the great things about space training is that everyone gets along regardless of their country's conflicts on Earth.
Space is one of those few things that humans do well together.
Has this followed through to your space expedition? What is it like up there with people you're working with?
Absolutely it has. You can see behind me the banderole of flags of countries that contributed to the International Space Station. And every day on board, we are reminded that we are an example, that every day we work together, every day we prove that when countries decide to put aside their differences, which exist and are true, but when we put aside our differences and focus on what we have in common, we can accomplish amazing things. And we are very proud here, astronauts, to be demonstrating that every day.
What can we learn and how can we implement what you've learned in space about getting along together on Earth?
I think the most important is to recognize that there are differences, there will be differences, and then respect each other for our differences, but then focus on what we have in common, which is huge. And one thing you get obvious when you look at the Earth seen from space is that it's just one big spacecraft for all of humanity. And we're all in the same boat, if you want, literally the same space boat, Mother Earth. And so I think it's just a matter of focus. If you focus on the differences, of course, they're there and they can become, you know, overwhelming. But if you focus on what we have in common, that's when you open the door to collaboration and getting further and maybe one day managing to work together and amazing things that we can achieve when we put our strengths together.
You've been in space for 6 months now. Are you nervous about coming back to Earth for your re-entry?
Well, you know, of course, I've gotten used to this place. So any change is a source of stress in a way. It took me a while to get used to this place here. Learn to fly initially was actually not so easy. Now I'm pretty agile, moving around. I can be upside down, it doesn't bother me. I can fly, I can bounce off the walls, and you know, I never lose my way. But it wasn't like that in the beginning. So this feels like home now. And I know that coming back to Earth, I will have to learn again to live with gravity. Learn again to walk and learn to live again with many, many people around me. This will be different, but I have no fear that I can adapt. That's the beautiful thing of human nature, that we can adapt.
What is your message to us and to young Canadians or young kids all around the world?
Life is a series of experiences, and that, you know, what you do with them is up to you, how you kind of process them and the lessons you learn from them. But the journey is as important, if not more important, than the destination. And I would tell young people, you know, it's important to find the dream that's in your soul. Find that sometimes it's a very, very little voice, and we can be afraid of our dream if it's huge and crazy. Me, I had this ridiculous dream. I wanted to understand everything. That's impossible. I'll never be able to do that. But that led me to go from one degree to the next and explore and learn languages and different cultures. I'll probably never reach my dream of understanding everything, of course, but I'll try. And that dream, which is more of a direction than a destination, is what keeps us moving. And if you don't have a dream, then someone else will tell you what to do. And that's just, that's just too bad. It's better if you decide yourself which way you go in the morning when you wake up. So find your dream and cherish it. It is your most important treasure. All right, bye-bye, Saara.
So that was my interview with David Saint-Jacques at the International Space Station. I'm so grateful for this opportunity because space travel is such a hot topic. We want to know more about the universe around us. Maybe one day you'll be in space. For CBCKidsNews.ca, I'm Saara Chaudry.